Excuse me, Commander Shepard. Could you spare a moment of your time? Commander Shepard, my name is Samesh Bhatia. Forgive the intrusion, but I have nowhere else to turn.
A lot of people want my help these days. What makes you special?
My wife was a Marine. She was in the 212 on Eden Prime. I've requested that my wife's body be returned to me for cremation, but the military has refused my request.
Why did they refuse your request? There's got to be some reason.
I don't know. All I know is that they have declared it impossible for my wife to be returned to me.
We'll look into it.
The man in charge of my case is Mr. Bosker. When I last saw him, he was in the expensive bar over there. Thank you for your time. I just want to give my wife a proper funeral, and the respect she deserves.
Human, delighted welcome. It is good to meet you.
I can't believe I landed a job here. This place is fantastic.
I could use a snack. Think there's any fish out in that lake?
Commander Shepard, I didn't expect to see you here. Did Ambassador Udina send you?
Have we met before?
No, but I know you well enough. I'm Executor Palin, head of CSEC. It's my job to know when someone like you arrives on the Citadel. Was there something you needed, Commander?
I get the feeling you're not too fond of humans.
No, I just don't trust your kind. Not yet. You humans are eager to take all the power you can get, and you're being given a lot. If the Council wants to make humanity their new favorite pet, that's their business. But I don't have to like it.
The Council treats us like second-class citizens. We have to fight for everything we get.
Good. Then fight for it. But don't expect the rest of us to just sit back and let you take it. I'm a busy man, Commander. Are we done here?
I'll be going now.
Goodbye, Commander.
This place seems strange. I wish there were more humans around. You have to be tough with these aliens. They won't respect you otherwise.
Don't believe the rumors. The consort would never reveal her secrets.
Of course she wouldn't. Be tossed out the nearest airlock if she did.
I suppose. Besides, Nick, the consort's nothing like the girls back on the colonies. She's...
You don't have to do it with her. You can just talk to her if you want.
Is that all you did, Jazz? Just talk?
I didn't say that.
Ha! I bet you did too.
Shut up, Fredericks.
Hello, Commander. Can I get you something?
Goodbye.
So long, Commander. Have a pleasant day.
Come on. Udina's presenting the Quarian's evidence to the Council.
Eden Prime was a major victory. Beacon has brought us one step closer to finding the conduit.
And one step closer to the return of the Reapers.
You wanted proof? There it is.
This evidence is irrefutable, Ambassador. Saren will be stripped of his Spectre status, and all efforts will be made to bring him in to answer for his crimes.
I recognize the other voice, the one speaking with Saren. Matriarch Benezia.
She must be working with the Geth, too.
Matriarch Benezia is a powerful biotic, and she had many followers. She will make a formidable ally for Saren.
I'm more interested in the Reapers. What do you know about them?
Only what was extracted from the Geth's memory core. The Reapers were an ancient race of machines that wiped out the Protheans. Then they vanished.
The Geth believe the Reapers are gods, and Saren is the prophet for their return.
We think the conduit is the key to bringing them back. Saren's searching for it. That's why he attacked Eden Prime.
Do we even know what this conduit is?
Saren thinks it can bring back the Reapers. That's bad enough.
Listen to what you're saying. Saren wants to bring back the machines that wiped out all life in the galaxy? Impossible. It has to be. Where did the Reapers go? Why did they vanish? How come we found no trace of their existence? If they were real, we'd have found something.
I tried to warn you about Saren, and you refused to face the truth. Don't make the same mistake again.
This is different. You proved Saren betrayed the Council. We all agree he's using the Geth to search for the conduit, but we don't really know why.
The Reapers are obviously just a myth, Commander. A convenient lie to cover Saren's true purpose. A legend he is using to bend the Geth to his will.
50,000 years ago, the Reapers wiped out all galactic civilization. If Saren finds the conduit, it will happen again.
Saren is a rogue agent on the run for his life. He no longer has the rights or resources of a Spectre. The Council has stripped him of his position.
That is not good enough. You know he's hiding somewhere in the Traverse. Send your fleet in!
A fleet cannot track down one man.
A Citadel fleet could secure the entire region, keep the Geth from attacking any more of our colonies.
Or it could trigger a war with the Terminus systems. We won't be dragged into a galactic confrontation over a few dozen human colonies.
I can take Saren down.
The Commander's right. There is a way to stop Saren that doesn't require fleets or armies.
No. It's too soon. Humanity is not ready for the responsibilities that come with joining the Spectres.
You don't have to send a fleet into the Traverse, and the Ambassador gets his human Spectre. Everybody's happy.
Commander Shepard, step forward. It is the decision of the Council that you be granted all the powers and privileges of the Special Tactics and Reconnaissance Branch of the Citadel.
Spectres are not trained, but chosen. Individuals forged in the fire of service and battle. Those whose actions elevate them above the rank and file.
Spectres are an ideal, a symbol, the embodiment of courage, determination, and self-reliance. They are the right hand of the Council, instruments of our will.
Spectres bear a great burden. They are protectors of galactic peace, both our first and last line of defense. The safety of the galaxy is theirs to uphold.
You are the first human Spectre, Commander. This is a great accomplishment for you and your entire species.
I'm honored, Counselor.
We're sending you into the Traverse after Saren. He's a fugitive from justice, so you are authorized to use any means necessary to apprehend or eliminate him.
Any idea where to find him?
We will forward any relevant files to Ambassador Udina.
This meeting of the Council is adjourned.
Congratulations, Commander.
We've got a lot of work to do, Shepard. You're going to need a ship, a crew, supplies.
You'll get access to special equipment and training now. You should go down to the CSEC Academy and speak to the Spectre Requisitions Officer.
Anderson, come with me. I'll need your help to set all this up.
Bastard didn't even thank you.
What do you expect from a politician? Come on.
Right behind you, Shepard.
I've always wondered if the Turians released the Genophage on their own, or if the Council secretly encouraged them.
Through all my time at CSEC, I never got the chance to witness a meeting of the Council in person.
Thank you.
Hello, Commander.
Show me what you've got.
Sounds good. Just let me set you up. Oh, this must be a mistake. System's telling me to offer you our select stock. Spectre? Well, I heard about that, but I didn't realize it was you. Sorry, Commander.
Just show me what you've got.
I'll open the rare stock for you, Commander. Enjoy.
Greetings, Earth Clan. I believe congratulations are in order, Commander Shepard. You are the first human to join the Spectres, yes?
It's a great honor.
One you are no doubt ready for. A word of warning, though. There are many eyes watching you now, Commander. Some of them want to see you fail. I, however, wish you only success. Perform well and you bring the Earth Clan one step closer to joining the Council. And if they let your people in, maybe there is hope for my own species one day, yes?
I should go.
Goodbye, Commander.
The ambassadors have this beautiful park to relax in, but most of them are too busy to ever use it.
Tranquil, calm, relaxing. Wake me when this is over.
I'll be with you in just a sec.
I need to talk to you about your work with CSEC.
I don't know what you're talking about. Now, if you don't mind, I need to get back to my customers.
This isn't a game, Jenna. These people are dangerous.
Now you sound like my sister. Why is everyone so concerned about me? I can take care of myself. I need to go. I'm not a stripper. I don't get paid to stand around and look pretty.
Tough girl.
CSEC always turned a blind eye to what went on in here. I think Fist was paying someone off.
Fist had a good thing going here. Too bad it got greedy. I got business here, but not with you.
Commander! What do you want?
What's bothering you, General?
I've seen a lot of horrible things in my days, and there's only one woman in this damn galaxy that helps me forget it.
This is pathetic. What could a woman do to put you in this state?
Because she rejected me. Me! Septimus Araka, General of the Turian Fleet.
Some general. What kind of example are you to your troops?
The troops can kiss my leathery backside. All I wanted was to retire and be with her. Look, kid, I appreciate what you're trying to do, but don't waste your time.
Never let the enemy see your weakness. You know that, General.
Enemies? The one place I always felt at peace was with her. But now, so you think it's that easy? Just straighten up and act like a general?
It damn well couldn't hurt.
Huh. Maybe you're right, Commander. Shaira's worth the effort, even if she won't have me back.
Now get up and get moving, General.
All right. I'll go to her. After I've had a cold shower or two. Say, you're a bright kid. Would you be interested in earning a few extra credits?
What do you want me to do?
There's an Elcor diplomat out there who believes Shaira gave up his secrets.
Why's that?
Because I told him,
Look, I just need you to convince him of the truth.
Why can't you tell him yourself?
Well, the last time he saw me, I was disparaging his ancestors and shouting his secrets in public. Take this data pad. It shows where I got my info. It will exonerate Shaira and convince the Elcor.
Who am I taking it to, and where is he?
His name is Zaltan. He's an Elcor diplomat. He's over in the embassies complaining about Shaira. Well, here's to soldiers acting like soldiers. Thanks, Commander. You know, you might make a good general yourself one day.
Not now. I'm watching the show. Go away. Let me drink your piss. Go away. Let me drink your piss.
Questions about Jenna. Meet me at CSEC Academy.
What did you just say?
Push off. I never did nothing to you. Damn newcomers. Think they can run the place.
What the hell was that about?
I guess we'd better go find out.
Hello, Commander.
I think I'll be going.
Sure thing, Commander. You have a good day now.
Hello again. Did you have any luck finding Shorban?
I found out you've been lying to me, Jaleed.
Lying? Why would I lie to you?
You forgot to mention the data about the Keeper.
He told you? I didn't mean for any of this to happen. I was afraid Shorban would kill me to get the data, so I... Well, I was hoping you'd take care of him.
I'm scanning the Keepers for Shorban, but you two need to stop fighting.
You're helping us? But... Well, if you say so. Well, if Shorban can forgive and forget, then so can I. I appreciate the help, Commander. I better go get that data analyzed.
I used to have an office here. Spent half my time doing paperwork.
If CSEC were better at its job, there'd be no need for bounty hunters like me.
Detective Chellick, come into my office. I want to discuss this in private.
No offense, Commander, but what the hell were you thinking?
Watch your tone, Chellick.
You could have blown Jenna's cover.
We were trying to help her.
I gathered that. It might seem cold letting her take all the risk, but we're keeping a close eye on her.
It's too dangerous. You need to find another way.
It's not that simple, Shepard. This job isn't easy and it's usually unpleasant. I'll take help anywhere I can find it. But since you're so concerned with her safety,
Maybe there's a way we can help each other.
It's nice to see you're still working all the angles, Chellek.
It's part of the job. Now, are you going to help me or not?
I'll help you, but I need some details.
I'm trying to track down an illegal arms producer. I just need some of their product. Thanks to Jenna's intel, I've learned there's a seller here on the Citadel. Meet our man named Jax. Pick up the mods and bring them back here. That'll give me everything I need.
Why are you so concerned about these mods?
We have access to some of the most sophisticated weaponry there is. It's what gives us our edge. What do you suppose happens when we lose that edge?
These give criminals an advantage we can't afford to let them keep.
I'll persuade Jax to tell me where these mods are coming from.
No. You tip Jax off, and all my leads will disappear faster than you can say bad bust.
Where can I find this Jax?
Jax is down in the lower level of the markets. I'll send word through our channels that you're the buyer. Good luck, Commander.
Hello, Commander.
So how about it, Garrus? Is this better than C-Sec?
Fighting a rogue specter with countless lives at stake and no regulations to get in the way? I'd say that beats C-Sec.
There may just be hope for you yet, Turian.
I've got big news for you, Shepard. Captain Anderson is stepping down as commanding officer of the Normandy. The ship is yours now.
She's quick and quiet, and you know the crew. Perfect ship for a Spectre. Treat her well, Commander.
This isn't right. The Normandy belongs to you.
You needed your own ship. A Spectre can't answer to anyone but the Council. And it's time for me to step down.
Come clean with me, Captain. You owe me that much.
I was in your shoes 20 years ago, Shepard. They were considering me for the Spectres.
Why didn't you ever mention this?
What was I supposed to say? I could have been a Spectre, but I blew it? I failed, Commander. It's not something I'm proud of. Ask me later and I'll tell you the whole story. For now, all you need to know is, I was sent on a mission with Saren, and he made sure the Council rejected me. I had my shot. It came and went. Now you have a chance to make up for my mistakes.
I won't let you down, sir.
Saren's gone. Don't even try to find him. But we know what he's after. The Conduit. He's got his Geth scouring the Traverse looking for clues.
We had reports of Geth in the Pharos system shortly before our colony there dropped out of contact, and there have been sightings around Novaria.
Find out what Saren was after on Pharos and Novaria. Maybe you can figure out where the Conduit is before he does.
The Reapers are the real threat.
I'm with the Council on this one, Shepard. I'm not sure they even exist.
But if they do exist, the Conduit's the key to bringing them back. Stop Saren from getting the Conduit, and we stop the Reapers from returning.
I'll stop him.
We have one more lead. Matriarch Benezia, the other voice in that recording. She has a daughter, a scientist who specializes in the Protheans. We don't know if she's involved, but it might be a good idea to try and find her. See what she knows. Her name's Liara, Dr. Liara Tassoni. We have reports she was exploring an archaeological dig on one of the uncharted worlds in the Artemis Tau cluster.
Maybe I can get to Novaria before the Geth.
It's your decision, Commander. You're a Spectre now. You don't answer to us.
But your actions still reflect on humanity as a whole. You make a mess and I get stuck cleaning it up.
I'll take care of Saren. You take care of the political fallout.
Not exactly the answer I was looking for, Shepard. Remember, you were a human long before you were a Spectre. I have a meeting to get to. Captain Anderson can answer any questions you might have.
Yes, Commander?
I want to know the truth about you and Saren. I want to know about the mission you were on together all those years ago.
We had intel on a rogue scientist being funded by Batarian interests. He was trying to set up a facility to develop illegal AI technology out in the Verge. Alliance intel had done all the work, but the Council wanted a Spectre involved. We compromised. I was assigned to help Saren in his investigation. We tracked the scientist to a refining facility on Kamala. He was hidden away somewhere inside, protected by an army of Batarian mercenaries. The plan was simple. Sneak into the plant, capture the scientist, sneak back out. Quick, quiet, and a minimum of bloodshed.
I'm guessing things didn't go as planned.
Saren and I split up to cover more ground. Then about halfway through the mission, there was a massive explosion in the refinery core. Officially, it was ruled an accident, but I think Saren detonated it on purpose to draw off the enemy guards.
Sounds like overkill to me.
The explosion tore the refinery to shreds. The whole place was on fire. Black chemical clouds poured out into the atmosphere. Nobody inside survived. There was a camp for the workers and their families nearby. Between the fires and the toxic fumes, the final death count was over 500. Mostly civilians. Saren didn't care. The target was eliminated, mission accomplished. And I ended up taking the blame. That ended all talk of me joining the Spectres.
Saren caused the explosion. How'd he pin it on you?
In his report, Saren accused me of blowing his cover. He said it was my fault the guards were ready for us. He claimed that's why it turned into a massacre. Saren's report was all the proof the Council needed to kill my chances of becoming a Spectre.
Why'd you let him get away with it?
Who do you think the Council was going to listen to? Me? Or their best agent? I had a bad feeling about him right from the start. I should have been more careful. Maybe I could have stopped things before they got out of hand.
Don't blame yourself, Captain.
I don't. I blame Saren. I think he wanted things to go bad. He was looking for an excuse to blow that refinery. Maybe he just likes the violence. Maybe he was just trying to make me look bad to keep humans out of the Spectres. If so, he pulled it off.
Why'd you let him get away with it?
Who do you think the...
Don't blame yourself, Captain.
I don't. Maybe he just likes the violence.
The only thing I care about is stopping Saren.
You're right, Commander. It's no good living in the past.
Any extra intel you can give me on our colony at Pharos?
The entire planet used to be one giant Prothean city. Mostly ruins now. But some of the infrastructure is still intact. The colony tried to build on what the Protheans left behind. We lost all contact with them when the Geth attacked.
How are you holding up?
Honestly, this isn't how I pictured my career coming to an end. Pushing papers really isn't my thing. But you're the one who can stop Saren. I believe in you, Shepard. If that means I have to step aside, so be it.
What do you know about the Artemis Tau cluster?
Not much. I've never been there myself. A handful of systems with a few small, uncharted worlds, but no real colonies. Might not be easy finding Dr. Tassoni out there. My advice is to look for the world with the Prothean ruins.
What can you tell me about Novaria?
Novaria's trouble. Always has been. The whole planet's basically a center for corporations to conduct illegal research. Watch your back there, Shepard. Spectres are about the only form of Citadel authority Novaria respects. But they aren't popular.
I should go.
I'll be here if you need anything.
Stand by, shore party. Decontamination in progress.
I heard what happened to Captain Anderson. Survives 100 battles and then gets taken down by backroom politics. Just watch your back, Commander. Things go bad on this mission, you're next on their chopping block.
Captain Anderson should be the one in charge. It's like I'm stealing the ship from him.
Yeah, the captain got screwed. But it's not like you could have stopped it. Nobody's blaming you. Everyone on this ship's behind you, Commander. 100%. Intercom's open. If you got anything you want to say to the crew, now's the time.
Listen up, Normandy.
This is your commander speaking. We have our orders. Find Saren before he finds the conduit. And I refuse to let anything get in the way of that mission.
The Council wants to ignore this.
That's no surprise. They've never helped us in the past. No reason they'd start now. But we don't need their help. We can do this on our own.
Wherever Saren goes, we'll follow.
Wherever he searches for the conduit, we'll be there. We will hunt him to the very ends of the galaxy and bring him down.
This is the most important mission any of us have ever been on.
The fate of an entire galaxy is at stake. We will stop Saren, no matter what the cost.
Well said, Commander. Captain will be proud.
Fancy speeches won't stop Saren from finding the conduit. If we really want to make the captain proud, we better get this bird in the air.
Yes, sir. Commander, something you need?
How's the Normandy performing? Is she everything they said she'd be?
She's the best ship in the fleet. If you've got a pilot who knows how to handle her. Balance isn't what you'd expect. Takes a while to get used to that oversized drive core we got stuffed in the back, and her power can sneak up on you if you're not careful. The Normandy's probably too much ship for your average Alliance pilot, Commander. Lucky for you, I'm anything but average.
I'd like to know my crew. Mind if I ask you a few questions?
I can see where this is going. You did a background check on me, didn't you? Well, I'll tell you the same thing I told the captain. You want me as your pilot. I'm not good. I'm not even great. I am the best damn helmsman in the Alliance fleet. Top of my class in flight school, I earned that. All those commendations in my file, I earned every single one. Those weren't given to me as charity for my disease.
I can't have you on this ship if you're going to infect my crew.
Infect the crew? Oh man, you have no idea what I'm talking about, do you? Okay, I've got Vrolik syndrome, brittle bone disease. The bones in my legs never develop properly, they're basically hollow, too much force and they'll shatter. Even with crutches and my leg braces, it's hard to get around. One wrong step and crack! It's very dramatic, but I've learned to manage my condition, Commander. Put the Normandy in my hands and I'll make her dance for you. Just don't ask me to get up and dance unless, you know, you like the sound of snapping shin bones.
Why does everyone call you Joker?
It's a lot shorter than saying Alliance Flight Lieutenant Jeff Moreau. Plus, I love to make little children laugh.
I was just thinking how much you remind me of Santa Claus.
Look, I didn't pick the name. One of the instructors in flight school used to bug me about never smiling. She started calling me Joker, and it stuck.
Why didn't you ever smile?
Hey, I worked my ass off in flight school, Commander. The world's not gonna hand you anything if you go around grinning like an idiot. By the end of the year, I was the best pilot in the academy. Even better than the instructors, and everybody knew it. They'd all got their asses kicked by the sickly kid with the creaky little legs. One guess who was smiling at graduation?
How'd you end up joining the Alliance?
Look, if you're looking for an inspirational tale of the crippled kid overcoming impossible odds, you're gonna be disappointed. My mother was a civilian contractor working for the Alliance. I basically grew up on the Arcturus station back when they were building up the fleets. Spend all that time around Alliance ships, there's a good chance you'll end up going to the Academy.
I need to know more about this Vrolik syndrome if I'm putting my ship in your hands.
Yeah, of course you do. It's an extremely rare condition. Nobody knows exactly what causes it. Genetic, maybe. It's treatable, but there's no cure. They classify my case as moderate to severe. I was born with over a dozen fractures, hip, thighs, ankles, my bones were already breaking in the womb. 100 years ago, I wouldn't have survived past my first year. Lucky for me, modern medical science has turned me into a productive member of society.
You're not gonna break a bone trying to fly the ship, are you?
I don't fly with my feet, Commander, so I'm fine as long as I'm in this chair. I gotta be real careful when I get up to take a piss, though. I can do my job as well as anyone on the ship. Better, actually. So don't worry about it.
I have to go.
Alright, see ya.
Commander, I'm picking up a signal from the planet's surface. It looks like an automated distress beacon.
Thank you.